सुपरमार्केट और सब्जी मंडी से दूर सोचिए एक ऐसी दुनिया जहां आपकी जरूरत की फ्रेश प्रोड्यूस 100% होम ग्रोन और ऑर्गेनिक हो और सारी सीजनल सब्जियां आपके घर की बालकनी या आंगन में से आए। वेल, थोड़ा अटपटा सा लग रहा है ना, पर ये मुमकिन किया है एडिबल रूट्स के एंटरप्रेन्योर कपिल ने। 2008 में कपिल ने यूएस से वापस आकर गुजरात में अपने 22 एकड़ के फार्म पे ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग करनी शुरू की। एक बढ़ती हुई कम्युनिटी के साथ इन्होंने 2010 में एडिबल रूट्स शुरू किया। इसका मेन एम था टू हेल्प मोर एंड मोर पीपल ग्रो देयर ओन फूड। उनका फार्मिंग का पैशन इंस्पायरिंग तो है ही, पर लोगों को अपना अर्बन किचन गार्डन बनाने के लिए भी इनकरेज करता है, जिससे वो फायदा उठा सकें फ्रेश ऑर्गेनिक होम ग्रोन प्रोड्यूस का अपने और अपने कम्युनिटी के लिए। न्यूयॉर्क में मेरा भी एक छोटा सा किचन गार्डन है जहाँ मैं काफी टाइम बिताती हूँ, और आज अर्बन गार्डनिंग की कुछ टिप्स के लिए मैं जा रही हूँ फार्म 8 कपिल से मिलने, जो मुझे देंगे एक क्रैश कोर्स इनटू मेकिंग द गार्डन मोर प्रोडक्टिव।
थैंक यू सो मच फॉर इनवाइटिंग मी टू योर लवली फार्म एंड योर ट्रेमेंडस रूट गार्डन। दिस इज फैबुलस व्हाट यू आर डूइंग हियर।
ग्लैड यू लाइक इट। सो विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दिस पैच ओवर हियर। व्हाट वी हैव हियर इज सम पीस ग्रोइंग एंड देन देयर सम ग्रीन अनियंस।
Green onions, amazing.
And these look like sarso, but they're actually turnips because they're the same family.
And this is like fresh, homegrown.
Yeah. Yes. The reason it tastes so sweet and so different is because you have eaten it so fresh.
Why, according to you, a person must grow their food?
I think there's two key things that growing your own food does. Yeah. There's a bond that you form with the food that you're eating. They're very fundamental questions. Who is growing our food?
Mm-hmm.
Where is it being grown?
Absolutely.
And how is it being grown? So essentially, these three questions represent the connection with our food. If you're eating something every day, day in and day out, you need to know these questions. And the second most important reason is the freshness. Okay, we don't realize, but the average distance, I think the food that travels in India now is about 800 kilometers.
Oh, okay. Wow.
Okay, and essentially what I have learned or researched is that within 24 hours, any fresh produce will lose half of its nutrition. Beyond that, the food is traveling so much. Essentially, what you're eating when it comes onto your plate, by when it's been at least 2 days, so you're essentially eating empty calories. So when you eat something that's grown in your own house, it's so rich in nutrition also, the nutritional density is so high that you're just not eating empty calories. And that directly corresponds to the flavor and the taste of the food as well.
Your tokris look so amazing.
Yes.
Can you show me how to do one of these?
Of course. So this is a simple bamboo tokri, a basket that you can easily get anywhere in the market. And then what this is it's a geotextile lining. Okay, it allows the soil to hold and the water to drain. So I'm going to put this first one.
Distinctly two different colors here.
Yeah, absolutely. Because that one has some soil in it, which is the brownish color.
Uh-huh.
And this one doesn't have any soil in it. It has lots of compost,
right.
Coco peat, vermiculite. This shiny thing that you see is vermiculite. It's a mineral that helps to hold water and nutrients.
Oh, okay. That's wonderful.
So now that you can see, this basket is almost ready. Okay.
Yes.
So what we are going to plant today is some spinach.
Yeah.
And then we'll plant a couple of plants of brinjals.
Okay.
It will grow taller. So by the time the spinach will grow and give you harvest multiple times, that's when the brinjal will start giving you some fruit. So that way you don't have to wait for something to come. It'll keep giving you again and again. About every week you'll get a harvest.
Every week?
Every week, yes.
That's amazing. Yes. Getting like homegrown palak for a family of four in the small tokri every week.
And the brinjal will almost last you a year. So it'll keep going, it'll come in waves, but it keeps giving fruit every few weeks. For almost a year, maybe sometimes even 2 years. So I'm going to start the palak first.
Yes.
Slightly.
Kitni quantity, like in a tokri this big?
Ek mutthi bhar is more than enough, yeah.
Okay.
More than enough, yeah. And then what I'm doing is now mixing the seeds with the soil.
Okay.
So that the seeds are buried in the soil and then they can grow when the watering is done. So what I'll do is I'm going to add another layer of soil on top of this.
All right.
From this one. So that way.
Okay.
And then some seeds that are left will be buried as well.
Perfect.
Now in the same tokri, we're going to plant some saplings of brinjals. Is it easy to plant?
Very easy to plant. It's a piece of cake. I thought it's going to be a lot more complicated than this.
That's it. And then now?
Then we water.
Now we're lightly going to water it. Cool. I think that's good.
That's good?
Yeah.
I really believe in eating food at its freshest. Nothing like eating what you planted right from the planter. Delicious. Can't beat the taste.